Hi, in this video, we will cover some important facts about gestational diabetes, that is a diabetes in pregnancy. This is very important because as we are seeing that the number of diabetics in pregnancy is increasing. Almost 1 in 6 pregnancies have a gestational diabetes. So the reason could be people who have not maintained a good weight before pregnancy or overweight, who have a family history of diabetes, who people who have a PCOD history, all these people are high likely to get a diabetes in pregnancy. So diabetes in pregnancy can be diagnosed at 24 to 28 weeks of pregnancy, usually second and third trimester. But as per the UK NICE guidelines, it can be screened even at the first trimester. So otherwise, as per American Diabetic Association guidelines, if it is somebody is detected diabetic in the first trimester, they are called as pre-existing diabetes, and somebody detected diabetic at 24 to 28 weeks, they are called as gestational diabetes. But as per the UK guidelines, people who are even diagnosed at first trimester also called as a gestational diabetes. So more or less, the sugar need to be screened, the diabetic is going to be screened in the first ANC checkup only, because many people have high insulin resistance. And if sugars comes to be high, it has to be properly controlled further to avoid maternal and fetal complications. So how to screen? So there are many guidelines. The accepted guidelines is you give a 75 grams of glucose water and check the sugars after 2 hours. The simplest way is if the after food 2 hours after oral glucose tolerance test, that is 75 grams of glucose, if the sugar comes less than 140, that is normal. If the sugar comes more than 140, it indicates a criteria for a gestational diabetes. So if somebody is a diabetic age, what are the different guidelines for the fasting? Suppose somebody is diabetic. In the normal adults, the target ranges are different. Like for example, in normal adults, if somebody is maintained around 125-130 fasting, we consider normal. And any postprandial sugars less than 200, we consider normal. But it is not so in pregnancy. In pregnancy, what we do, the target blood sugar level should be, the fasting should be less than 95. And 2 hours after food, blood sugar should be less than 140. So remember this, the target blood sugar is different from normal population. And to maintain so strict control of sugars is challenging. What happens many times, the pregnant woman who is having a gestational diabetes or a diabetes have to check her sugars fasting, 2 hours after breakfast, pre-lunch, post-lunch, pre-dinner and post-dinner, almost a 6 times pricking. So to avoid this, now use the technology. Nowadays a CGM is there, continuous glucose monitoring. Use continuous glucose monitoring so that it will detect your sugar spikes, so that it is easy to achieve a target, it avoids pricking. So how to control blood sugars in pregnancy? One is diet and lifestyle. When it comes to the diet, there are 2 things. Normally, for a normal type 2 diabetic people, we advise a low carb diet with a optimum for proteins and a fiber, which will effectively control the sugars. But in pregnancy, we cannot avoid a low carb or a keto diet because pregnancy is a ketogenic state. Thus, we have to give at least, as per the guidelines, 175 grams of carbohydrates for a pregnant woman having diabetes. We have to give 30% as a fats and at least 20 grams as a protein. So in this, we are not restricting carbohydrates, but we want sugar level to be very strict in such way that you are giving carbohydrates as pregnancy is ketogenic state. As you know, carbohydrate will spike the sugars, but sugar has to be under tight control in pregnancy to avoid complications. Such way it's really challenging to control the sugars. And people with a mild diabetic, all those things can have easily give a drug called metformin. This is commonly used drug. It can be given morning and night. And with the metformin, if somebody can able to maintain the fasting sugar of less than 95 and 2 hours after food sugar of less than 140, it's good. But if these targets are not maintained, we have to add insulin. Insulin, short-acting insulin, or a Levimir long-acting insulins. Only these few insulins are approved in pregnancy. So ultimately, the target blood sugar of fasting sugar less than 95, 2 hours after breakfast sugar of less than 140 should be maintained in pregnancy. And CGM is the best way to monitor the progress of the sugars. If you have this, and depending on the possible maternal and fetal complications, we have to set the target and strict control is required. This is in brief about gestational diabetes. So everyone should understand and know about gestational diabetes, because the target blood sugars and the treatment is slightly strict compared to the normal adult type 2 diabetes. Mm-hmm.